Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Alex Ventura, and today I'm going to be going over Joel Grimes Beauty Brushes and how I used them for this headshot. I actually have two headshots ready. We'll see if I get to both of them. The headshots I've already gone through and done my basic retouching, and it's pretty much ready for me to do my final color tonings, any additions that I want to add to it. And then I'm going to go ahead and try out some of these brushes and see what I can do to add more to the image. I've asked the model to come in with a very neutral palette, not too heavy on lip gloss or anything like that, no eyelash extension, so we can try to use some of these brushes for the shot. So let's go ahead and dive right into it. So there's several groups I've already had here. I've already imported all of them, and there's a ton of different brushes you can use if you want to draw on individual hair strands or maybe add a ponytail or a bunch, depending on your image. There's a lot of different brushes. So I've kind of already grouped all the different hair ones into one master group. And then same thing with eyelashes. You have the top, bottoms, and individual. And they're all different angles, so if you have the face turned a little bit more like in this shot, or if you have it straight on, there's different angles for that. You also have lip gloss, top and bottom. Then you have iris if you want to add a little more color to it. And then you also have catch light. So maybe the light wasn't exactly the same the right angle you wanted to get an optimal catch light in the eye, and you want to come back and add it, you can with these brushes. So we'll go ahead and start off with just adding a catch light. Maybe emphasize a little bit more of a reflector here in this bottom corner. So I'm just going to go add a new layer. Let's go ahead and name this catch light. And let's say I wanted to get this square here. I'm gonna turn off spacing. I'm gonna zoom in. And also make sure it's white. Change the angle just slightly. And then we'll reduce it over here. Actually, I'll just put it on the new layer. Left. This way I can adjust the opacity individually instead of having the same one, or the same layer, should I say. And just see the different blending modes, see which one I want to use. Probably soft light now. Actually, I'll just keep it normal. Go down a bit. Let's zoom out. And it's just very subtle. I'm just going to add a subtle catch light, not as strong. Yeah, like say 10 on this one. Let's go back to this one, maybe drop it a little bit. 15. There you go. So I'm just going to group these together. And if I can type. So there you go. Maybe I'm just reduce it a little bit more. There we go for the catch light. Now I'm going to add a new layer. And I've cleaned up some of the strands, but don't exactly like the way it looks on the edge. So I'm going to go to hair. And I believe it's under edges. So I'm gonna switch. I'm gonna actually use eyedropper and get a color close to her hair. There's a dark one. Let's just see what this looks like. It's not too bad. So of course some of these you're gonna have to test out and use. You're not gonna be able to use all of them. And there may be a few favorites you might like. And always go back to those. There's one I used earlier that I'm looking for. Let's see, right there. Actually, I'm bring this in a little bit more. Actually, I think this was it. So I'm gonna go ahead and control delete the earlier brush, and let's just add this here. And then I can also transform it and bring it in on here on the top. Maybe I don't want it as far sticking out, so I'm just gonna tuck this in a little bit. Name this layer so I remember what it is later. So just you can play with it, you can add hair in different spots. See if there's anything on this side. Maybe I just want to add a strand. So I'm going to turn off spacing and I'm going to turn the angle. And actually, I'm going to flip it up. Try that. And then since this is on a new layer, I just create a mask and I'll just go back to a basic brush. And I can just cover up going right there. Let's go back and turn that on and off and see how that looks. So I definitely like this side, not a fan of the other side so much. So probably just gonna go ahead and delete that out. Or just leave it like that. Just making sure there's not another brush I wanna try before. Of course, I gotta delete the mask. Actually, that may work, so let me go ahead and delete everything on this side. Go back to that brush. And I'm gonna flip. And let's just rotate it slightly. That's a little bit too much. It's about there. And of course, I'm not going to have it coming out of her nose. I'll just cover that up, but I just wanted these strands right here. And then I'll apply that mask back. And I'm just painting away what I'm not going to use. So that's a great thing about these brushes is you can go back and change the opacity, change the size, change the orientation, and then brush away what you don't need. let's say I'm going to get rid of these strands right here, just keep these closer, so let's brush that off. Actually, I'm going to change that. So there we go, on and off. On, off. So just added a few more strands, maybe not so perfect. And let's say maybe we want to add a few more right here at this little curved portion. So if you shot this outside, you want to add like a little hair flip. Go ahead and add a new layer. I'm going to show you what that looks like. So you could have, let's just flip it right now. So you can make it look like her hair is flipping, blown in the wind. But of course in this shot, we don't need that. Let's see what that looks like. So a lot of this you will have to go through and check out each brush individually. There is a PDF included with the brushes that you can refer to. Let me pull that up. So here you go. So of course this is for the lip gloss, but you can see quick examples of how it looks. You may want to keep that open instead of going through like I'm doing right now. Let me actually just go ahead and do that. Let's see what the brushes for the hair look like. See if I can find it a little bit faster this way. Looking for one for the top. So I may be able to use this portion of the hair right there, an even spray. So let's try that one. An even spray. So I need to flip it. Make it larger. And then now I just need to rotate it. Apply a mask again. And of course, if you want your hair a little bit more perfect, you wouldn't be adding this, but I'm going for a little bit more realism. So this is hair top. Okay, so let's see what else we can add. If you want to add a little bit of lip gloss, so I'm going to add a new layer. I'm just going to actually change this to beauty brushes. And I can't spell. So I'm just going to drop these in here now that I'm done with those. And this will be lip gloss top. Let's go ahead and keep it separate. And then I'll do duplicate that. You can also just do Control D. Just right click, duplicate layer. And then I'll just do bottom. Whichever way is easier for you, you can also go to layer, duplicate there. So I'm just gonna go back, duplicate it here, and bottom. So then we'll start with the bottom. And let's look for one a little more on an angle that kind of matches her. Go ahead and change this to white. Of course, that's not gonna match, but it's a lot bigger. Let's see what that looks like. So then, of course, I can transform it afterwards. And warp. So there's the bottom. And I'm going to apply a mask and brush out what I don't want. Then I can just reduce the flow if I want to soften it up with not a gradual turn off. So let's turn that on and off. And then I can just reduce the opacity, start from zero, and go up a little bit. Just add a little bit more shine, and I'll go ahead and brush off some more of this bottom area. Now let's look one for the top. And with these kind of brushes, I'm using my mouse, and then when I'm masking in, I'm going back to my Wacom tablet pen. It's a little bit better control for myself. This is an angle. Just make sure I'm on the right layer. Put that flow back to 100%. Enlarge it a little bit. There we go. So I'm just reshaping it to kind of match her lips a little bit better. Let's just say there. So like that, so let's just see what 20 looks like. Actually, I'm not liking the bottom one as much, so I'm going to go ahead and let's just do that one over. And switching back, and let's see. See if there's an angled one over here. It looks like these are all center. just try this one and see how it works. And let's match it 20% as the top. And then I'm going to just warp it a little bit. So I do like it at 20%. I'm going to put it back at 100 so I can warp it and see what exactly how I'm affecting it. And there we go. Applying a mask so I can kind of clean up this little area here and then that area there. I'm going to reduce the flow. Alright, so I said 20% earlier. There we go. Just adds that little subtle shine to it. You, of course, you can make yours a lot stronger or darker depending on how you want it. I'm just gonna drop these in there. That's how I want that. Now, since this shot is not straight on, I'm not gonna mess with the iris. I think the only thing left is the eyelashes. So let's see what we can do here. Of course, I can go individually and add some in. And go in and take a color from here. Of course, I need to put the flow back to 100% and try and grab a color again. Okay, there we go. Delete that. And let's see. This is for the bottom. I wanted to go here and add a few. Just changing the size, adding them where I want to add them. And of course, I can always change the angle here as well. Now, if I didn't want to do it individually, if I wanted to add a group, I can check out the bottom and let's see what there is here. Since her eye is the other direction, let's try flipping it and then rotating it a bit. That's close. Let's try another one. That could work. So I'm just going to flip it. Rotate a little bit. Of course, you can do the rotation afterwards, but just trying to see what how close I can get here. Now I'm just warping it again to follow the actual shape of the eye. Now if this is too long, we can just do same thing. Create a mask and brush away some of these ones a little bit longer. See if there's another one we can use for the other side. I may just use that same one, not flip it, and transform it to fit. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. So I'm just going to put it on a new layer. Flow 100%. And let's put it back right about there. Let's transform that. So I'm just going to add a mask and brush away the ones I don't want. So it's just a lot of manipulation to make it work the way you want it. And let's see if I can pull that up a little bit more. There we go. Go back to the brush and maybe make these a little bit shorter. There we go. Bottom on both sides is applied. And actually, this is the bottom, not the top, so. Rename that. Alright, so I just created the two new layers. I'm going to rename them. And let's switch to top brushes. See if there's. See what this looks like. That may work. I'll save that one. A little bit stronger than I want. Let's see what that looks like, this orientation. So I'm just going through selecting different ones to see which one I like. Let's try what this one looks like. To the left, flip it, make it a little bit smaller. And that way I can just go back and transform both of these. close. So now I'm going to transform the other side. Now I just need to add that curve back a little bit. And this time I'm gonna add the mask and brush away some of the ones that are a little bit longer than I like. Just that one. So I'm just going back and just masking away the ones I wanted, do not want. So there we go. And actually I want to adjust this line right here. There we go. So if I zoom out, let me check this other side, see if there's any I want to mask away. That side looks pretty good. I'm going to drop that in. These are the changes. Of course, you can go more heavy-handed if you want. You can go a little bit less. It's just using these brushes to add a little bit more of that was initially there. Of course, you could get someone with a blank slate and add everything, or you could just use it to make little adjustments and corrections as needed. Switch to the other photo, and let's see if that one can give a good example of the iris. I'm gonna jump over. And let's look at the irises. And let's see. Color picker to get a light color. And then I'm just going to open that up. Just double click that and just drag that up a little bit to get a little bit lighter color. Of course, bring the size down. That once. Actually, we'll go back. Let's do a little bit lighter color. And then I can resize that later. So this will be just left. Iris right. Do the same thing. Maybe I'll rotate it just a bit so it's not 100% the same. And then we can play with, see what color does to it. Soft light. Not much. Duplicated it after I created the brush, so let's just do that. I can just reduce the opacity. Match that. both of these are 40. And then I'm just going to add a mask. Go back to the basic brush. That way I can paint this way. And then I'm gonna make this one a tad smaller. Back to the brush and then paint away right there. Switch eyes, paint away. So we can see what that looks like on and off. Scooping those back, doing the same thing. I'm gonna add a couple more layers. Top lashes.